Hey guys, today's a really exciting video. I was gonna wait and do this, but then I thought, why wait? I'm really excited about it right now. So I went to Walgreens and I got a couple Halloween things, specifically for Halloween, makeup stuff and just fun stuff, mostly makeup. And I'm gonna test it out for you guys as we open them because that's really fun. I love doing that. I can never wait till I get home to open something new that I bought, always, because I don't drive, so I'm always a passenger. So whenever we're driving home from a store, I'm opening it. And Priscilla's like, don't open it. And yes, there has been a couple accidents, but it's worth it because I was able to see it. And let's just get started and try all of this stuff out. So first of all, I got the Sinful Colors Glow-in-the-Dark Nail Polish. I don't know why, but I got it because I thought it would just be fun. So we're just gonna paint it right over my white, because I'm assuming you can paint it over like colors. I'm gonna let it dry and then I'll take you into a dark area of our house, which is like none because our place is so windowy. So I wonder if you're supposed to put multiple coats on. Is there anything toxic in here? Like radioactive? Apply two coats, it says. Okay, shake gently. I don't think I shake gently. Hopefully that was not the key to making this glow in the dark. I see nothing when I do that, but I guess I wouldn't. It's not that dark. I can't let
you open it all. Is that in a picture? That's weird.
Right? As I'm saying, I try it with every camera.
You need a black light.
A black light?
Yeah, that would show up.
But it shows up in person. Why wouldn't it show up on camera?
It's a bad camera.
It's an iPhone. I swear, I don't know why you can't see it. There's gotta be a reason. I mean, you kind of see it super bright there, like right after a flash. I also got these two Jordana cat eyeliners. I just thought they would be kind of cool. Oh, okay, it does not open the way I thought it would. I am not a fan of eyeliners that have brushes, only because they're harder for me to use. And I did not even realize these had. And they open, okay, let me ask you something here. Which way would you open this? I open it like this, and the tube of product is here, gonna fall out kind of thing. I feel like that's backwards, but whatever. I cannot draw a straight line to save my life. The blue is super pretty. I will say that has like a really pretty sheen, and the black, it's a black liner. It's just harder to make a perfect line because it's not like a pen. But those things, yeah, they're cool. Where's my receipt? I can tell you guys the prices for once. Jordana's were $2.99 each, and the Glow in the Dark Nail Polish was $1.99, so it was like super cheap. I think the blue would be really cute to wear like on some kind of like mermaid look. All right, next thing. Let's just jump to something super fun because I just love super fun stuff. So I got spray on blood. I don't know what I'm gonna use this for. I don't know how it's gonna look, but I really wanted to try this. It just looks so cool. And I think, yeah, it was $1.99. So why not? Let's just see what it is. So let me see. Allergic reaction. Should wash off within a few days. What the heck? All right, we're not going out this weekend, so I'll spot test it really quick on my arm. That's cool looking, very red. I'm just gonna like wait to make sure I don't break out in hives or something crazy. And then we can try it on my face because I think that's more fun. It says wait 60 minutes, but we're not waiting 60 minutes. I'm just seeing if I initially feel really itchy, and I don't. So let's do this. And I just wanna make sure that I don't get it on my dress. Dang, that does dye your skin. Oh my God, dude. I just wiped all of the blood off and it's like dyed my skin. Okay. Except if it falls on my skirt. All right, let's try this. Where should I put it? I feel like it would look better on my forehead. This is actually really scaring me. Can you see me? I swear to gosh, if you can't see me, I'm gonna be so mad. Okay, I'm assuming you're supposed to let it drip like that. It's a very, what do you call that? Wet formula. All right, I wanna stop it from dripping there, yeah. I think that looks better. He's going. That looks so cool, dude. Oh my God, that looks really cool going through my makeup like that. My day was done, so I'm not even like mad about that. Obviously, I wouldn't put it there if I was going anywhere tonight. That's really cool. I mean, it definitely doesn't look as real as it could because it's such a red blood, but I ain't hating on it. I like the fact that it sprays on, so it definitely looks like boom, you know? Like it looks cool. So that is not bad, $1.99. That is a good purchase. I would say go for that. And now I think my face is gonna be dyed like right down there. That's super fun, but okay, now I can take Bruce's shirt off. Next thing. Oh my gosh. So this is the Fantasy Makers Wildly Wicked and Mysterious. Never died. Hopefully that's kind of sort of where it was. False lashes. I love false lashes. I'm obsessed and I spend a ton of money on them because I don't know, they're kind of expensive and they add up. This one, how much was it? $3.99. I just thought these would be kind of cute. So let's try one of them on. All lashes look cute, like in their box, but sometimes I get them home and like they don't even do anything for me and I'm like, oh, why didn't I buy these? So let's try these guys. I have two false lashes on right now. So these kind of look like feathers. They're very interesting. So let's see. Very thick band. I hate thick bands. I might actually have to cut this one, but let's just try it on as is. I guess I have small eyes. Holy crap, these are long. Okay, so aside from these being super freaking long, so they kind of hurt my eye because they're like in here, this would probably be a little higher on most people because your eye is like wider. It's like wrapping around my eye. It definitely gives that bird effect. The only thing I don't like, and maybe it's like a good thing for people who are going for that bird like kind of like look, is that these lashes like are straight. I like lashes to give me more width to my eye, I guess, or height to make them look bigger, and these definitely don't make them look any taller. And but these are cool. I like this a lot. I'm definitely gonna have to trim it and play around with it a bit, but I think they're pretty cool. Very heavy. Make sure you have a good lash glue. And those were from Wet n Wild. Next thing, I'm not putting my eyelash back on. I'm just not doing my eyelashes back on because we have more. Yes, we do. I bought some strip adhesive from Kiss. I don't know if it's any good because I've never tried it before, but I couldn't find the duo and I wanted to make sure I was stock full of eyelash glue. So this I'm really, really excited about. Oh my God, I'm so excited. This is gonna take a little bit to put on, but I do wanna show you guys this. This is Fright Night by Ardell. And they're Spooky Lashes Mesmerizing. The box is like so big and they have top and bottom lashes in here. And there was a bunch of them, a bunch of different kinds, and I was really wanting to buy all of them because they were really gorgeous. So here we go. These are not dummies, so I think they're gonna be a little long for my eye again. Okay, I really messed up this one. I shouldn't have done the thumbnail. I don't know what I was thinking. Let's just put this bad boy on. He's full of plastic, that plastic glue that they put on there. Oh, I love this lash. Oh my gosh. That is a super cute lash. Ardell never lets me down. I love so many Ardell lashes. All right, and then these bottom lashes. Bottom lashes are kind of hard to put on, for me at least. I'm in love with this lash. I would wear this normally. This is like the kind of lash I've been looking for, to be honest. Something that really stands out. That went on oddly well. That's weird. I've never gotten a bottom lash that easy. I must be having good luck. Ah, I love bottom lashes. If you have smaller eyes and want to make them look bigger, bottom lashes are exactly like what you need. Oh my gosh, I love this. What do you guys think? The bottom lashes were literally the easiest ones I've ever put on in my entire life. They just look really nice together. And what was this called again? Mesmerizing. I'm so in love. These are so worth it. How much were these? Were these like really expensive? $3.99. Oh my god, so this is the same as the Wet n Wild ones. Yeah, these are definitely like way favoriter, if that makes sense. Next one, we're just gonna leave that on. It looks so cool, dude. Okay, this is really cool. This was $3. This was a Harley Quinn lipstick. I don't know, I'm just kind of obsessed. I just got it because I wanted to see what it would look like. I'm not trying it on right now because I have to tape a thumbnail and I'm gonna look really crazy if I have blood, bright red lipstick, and blue eyes. It's gonna look really weird, but this is the color. I mean, it's just a normal red. It's actually a red I do not care for, but I mean, come on, you gotta have a Harley Quinn. If you see that in a store, how do you pass that up? I think I could probably make it work for a Halloween costume, but it's definitely not an everyday shade of mine. Almost like an apple, I would say. But yeah, Harley Quinn, so cool. The other shades, there was like a dark purple and like another red. So, I mean, there was just not a nude or anything, so I just went with this one. Next thing, and we are saving the best for last. So this is the Fantasy Makers Painter's Palette from Wet n Wild. They had like three or four different colors. I have a couple of these, but this one I do not. And I think the other ones might be bad anyway because I got them like last year, but ow, oh my god. This is why I don't open stuff for myself. Bruce and I are going to this really fun concert where we have to dress up like zombies. I thought this would be good to do our makeup. Oh, I remember, this is so hard to open. What the hell? Okay, be very careful because these apparently just like pop off. That wasn't even like connected. There's no way that came off when I was opening it. So like, oh, they're nice and smooth. Okay. I love that they're nice and smooth and definitely buildable. Ooh. I like the consistency of this. This is really nice. Brown. Ooh, the brown is really nice. I was really excited about the gold, so let's see. But that looks really, really, really nice. I love this palette. I think it's great. Like I said, I have a couple of these. They're by far dried out now. That's why I was so, like, impressed that they were creamy, because mine are not creamy anymore. They're really, like, hard. $2.99 in She-Wolf. So that's really good. So last but not least, I'm super excited about this. Got this Be Sweet temporary hair color. I don't know why I got it in blue. I think she just looked really cute. And I was like, oh, look how cute. But she's blonde. So, I mean, we're not going to look alike. But I got it anyway. All right, let's definitely read the instructions on this one. Jake, what? Pull a piece of hair out to do this on, I guess. Easier said than done. Let's test it really quick so I can feel. Okay, this one's turned out. I don't know what I expected to smell. It smells like hairspray. Let's do it on this piece.
This is hard to do by myself. First, come help me.
Jesus. Oh my god, it actually working. Oh my gosh. I wasn't sure how it was gonna look on my color of hair. Was it brushed through or just let it dry? Cause blindness. This product may not be used for drying eyelashes, right? Oh. That scared me for a second. I guess I should have read all the instructions. That's cool looking. I don't know. It's cool. Okay, so definitely it looks and it feels like crispy-ish. And you can tell, like, it's not perfectly dyed. But I think it looks really cute from afar. You would, like, not even really tell. I don't know. It smells really good. So that's, like, a huge plus for me. If it smelled, like, disgusting, I would hate it. And I think it actually works on black hair, so you're good to go with any hair color, pretty much. If it works on my black hair, it'll work on yours. So that was it for my Halloween haul. I hope you guys enjoyed this. It was super fun trying all these products out. And now I get to show Bruce all this stuff. He's like, what are you doing? I'm gonna take some snapshots too. Oh my god, I totally got on my dress, didn't I? I forgot again. But thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down below any other videos you want to see or any other Halloween products that you've seen in your drugstores that you want me to try out. I'm definitely trying to look for more to look at and, you know, just test out and see how they work. So let me know down below, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.